NBC News, Decision Night in America. Here's Lester Holt.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Decision Night in America here at NBC's Democracy Plaza. It is 7 p.m. in the East. The polls have just closed in six states, and we have our first projections up on the iconic face of 30 Rockefeller Plaza. NBC News projects that Donald Trump will win the state of Indiana. When the votes are counted, we project that Donald Trump will win in Kentucky as well. Vermont goes to Hillary Clinton, the projected winner in Vermont. We're watching Virginia. The polls have closed there. Too early to call Clinton, however, leading in Virginia. Georgia, also too close to call. And South Carolina, too early to call. Trump leads in South Carolina. All night long, they'll be watching the race to 270 electoral votes. Here's how it stands based on those calls. Trump with 19, Clinton with 3. And we map it out on the ice for you on Democracy Plaza. That map will fill in with a lot of red and blue before this night is over. But again, 270 is the magic number that will elect our next president. Starting with Andrea Mitchell at Clinton headquarters. Hello, Andrea.
Good evening, Lester. This is the night that Hillary Clinton has been waiting for.
Hey there, Lester. Donald Trump is watching the returns come in at Trump Tower. He's surrounded by his family and his close aides. The campaign says that they are confident. They're already touting a record turnout.
That I think, and just in this respect, if Clinton wins this election, she's going to win it because of this Southeast corridor. And if Donald Trump wins this election, it's going to be because he overperforms in the. I mean, that's what's going on here.
Remember, Florida has two time zones. So while the polls have closed here, as you go out to the panhandle, the polls are still open for, well, till 7 o'clock that time, and then people can continue to vote as long as they've been in line. It's likely that we're going to have a pretty long night here because of how close things are.
A poll closed in Virginia about 25 minutes ago. Results slowly starting to come in. I don't think we have any yet. Looking at where they stand right now in the Commonwealth, well, actually, there are some results already. And Donald Trump seems to be leading so far at 57% of the vote to 38% for Hillary Clinton at this particular time.
Welcome back from our election center. It is 7:30 p.m. in the East, and polls have just closed in three states, including two very important swing states. Let's take you through them right now. The state of Ohio, too close to call at this hour. North Carolina, too early to call. West Virginia, NBC News projects when the votes are counted, Donald Trump wins West Virginia. It's a state where his message played well. Its coal industry has taken a beating. Hillary Clinton made a misstep there when she talked about putting coal workers out of a job. Trump gets West Virginia. As we look at the race to 270 now, we move down to the ice there on Democracy Plaza. The map filling in. Clinton right now with 319 electoral votes to Trump at this early hour in this contest. What are you seeing in these as we put them up here, Chuck?
If she wins Florida, she's going to win it down in South Florida. The fact that she has a lead right now in the raw vote before we have anything out of Broward County, you're going to have a lot of nervous Trump people right now and a lot of very, very excited Clinton.
Welcome back, Democracy Plaza, here on this election night, decision night in America. Just to keep in mind, we're about 15 minutes away from 8 o'clock Eastern, and we'll see a slew of poll closing, 16 states plus the District of Columbia.
You know, these were.
I'm going to interrupt you because we've got a call here in South Carolina. NBC News projects when the votes are in, Donald Trump wins South Carolina. Let's look at the, we can go down to the map there and look at where we things stand now in the electoral count. There it is, the race to 270. 33 for Trump, 3 for Clinton. The night is still early. The map barely filled in.
What you're going to focus on? Let me tell you this. It is Florida, Florida, Florida. If he loses Florida, he needs Pennsylvania and Michigan. He can't just get away with winning one of them.
Here's what we're learning in Virginia. Polls there closed at 7 o'clock with 25% of the votes in so far. Donald Trump is leading. Hillary Clinton, 53 to 42%.
We are back on this decision night in America. It is 8 o'clock in the East, one of the biggest moments of the night, as polls have just closed in a slew of states, 16 in all, plus the District of Columbia. Let's take you through where things stand right now. Florida, we've been watching that raw vote come in. Right now, that is too close to call in Florida. Pennsylvania, another big one, battleground state, too early to call. Pennsylvania, too early to call. New Hampshire, too early to call. Now we've got a bunch of states here in which there are projected winners, starting with Alabama. We project that Donald Trump wins Alabama. In Connecticut, Hillary Clinton, the projected winner. Delaware will also go to Hillary Clinton. The District of Columbia to Hillary Clinton. Illinois, her home state, goes to Hillary Clinton, as well as the state of Maryland. And Massachusetts, also in the Clinton column. Mississippi, we project that Donald Trump wins in Mississippi. New Jersey to Clinton. Oklahoma, the projected winner, Donald Trump. Rhode Island, Hillary Clinton. And Tennessee, Donald Trump. Let's look at the count right now, the race to 270. At this hour, based on those projections, Clinton stands with 75, Trump with 66 in the race to 270. Now, a couple others we want to mention right now. We're watching Maine. It is too early. Actually, we're looking at Missouri up there, but too early. Maine is too early, but Clinton is leading there in Mississippi. No, I'm sorry. No, that was Missouri. I'm sorry. My bad there. Missouri was too early. We got that straight, and Trump is leading there. And there is the map now as the colors begin to fill in and on the race to 270. So when let's put up, if we can put up the Florida numbers and show you where they are. I mean, right now we have it as too close to call, but Clinton with a 49-48 lead.
Hey there, Lester. I just spoke with a GOP source in Ohio, a high-level source who tells me that they believe it is going to go down to the wire in Ohio. The Clinton team, on the other hand, is also feeling quite good about that state. It's a state, remember, that Donald Trump visited 26 times, the state that he was leading with many of the polls, the state that they started to feel very confident in. But now the Clinton campaign is saying that they are feeling pretty confident as well. They're optimistic.
Because, look, the turnout, the fact is everybody has higher turnout. And I'm going to give you an example of how Trump territory is turning out in much bigger numbers.
They're getting a little nervous in Michigan because the Democratic areas of Detroit and Flint are not showing the kind of vote that they had wanted to see. It's obviously early, but it's raining. They're a little worried about this. Michigan could be very tight. As you know, both Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump were there only yesterday, and it would be far more important for Donald Trump's path. He really wants to flip a blue state.
How do you feel about Pennsylvania?
Good about Pennsylvania. In fact, we think between Pennsylvania and Virginia and North Carolina, I mean, I think, again, it's still early. You got to see the rest come in, but we're feeling really good.
And Chuck Todd has moved over to the map here. He's trying to figure out where things stand right now as we wait some of these big states.
A little bit, but you know, we need to remind people here, Virginia, we moved to too close to call. Now, the numbers have been creeping up. There's still a lot of Northern Virginia vote still to go. As you know, Loudoun, as Loudoun goes, so goes things. So that's the good news for Clinton.
We are back now from our election center here at 30 Rock in New York City. It's 9 o'clock in the East, 6 in the West. Polls have just closed in 14 more states. Take a deep breath as we take you through it. NBC News projects that Hillary Clinton will win in her now home state of New York. And now we have a slew of Trump calls, starting with Texas, Trump the projected winner. In Kansas, Trump wins. Louisiana, Trump is the projected winner. Nebraska, Donald Trump. We project that North Dakota will go to Donald Trump, as well as South Dakota and Wyoming, all those in the Trump camp. And let's look at the 270 now, the race to 270. Here's where they stand. Donald Trump at 137 electoral votes. Hillary Clinton with 104 based on those projections. Now, some other places we're watching, Michigan, we've talked a lot about how close things are. Too close to call right now. Arizona, another important state where Clinton's made some ground up. Too early to call. Colorado, too early. Minnesota, right now we have it listed as too close. Moving over to New Mexico right now. Too early, but Clinton right now leads in New Mexico. And finally, Wisconsin, where we visited in the last half hour. Too early to call. We want to take a look again now at Florida. Florida is too close to call, but look at the numbers there. Very, very close. A difference of roughly 140,000 votes.
We will not call this before midnight.
You think Florida's going to keep it hanging out there?
I promise you that. We will not call this before midnight. Will somebody put up the Ohio board? You guys got to see this.
Okay.
Please put up the Ohio board, because the margin is so ridiculously tight that it's sort of emblematic of all the battleground states right now. Look at it. How about that, Brokaw?
2,700 votes.
2,700 votes there in Ohio. Still a lot of vote out there, but with 37% reporting. But I feel that 2,700, that tells you Virginia, which we're going to be here a while.
Yeah.
That tells you North Carolina.
Let's look at North Carolina.
That one is another one.
Let's look at North Carolina. All right, 3,700 vote difference right there.
That's with 3 million votes cast so far. Yes. They've been counted.
The bottom line is, turnout has been shattered on both bases. We've been telling you this. Blue counties, red counties.
And there's there's the red and blue states as they stand right now, based on the projections. There's got to be some fingernail biting right now.
No, absolutely right. First of all, Virginia was something they were so confident in. They've got Terry McAuliffe as the governor. They've got Tim Kaine, former governor, senator, as the running mate. They actually took money out of Virginia advertising. They were that solid, they thought, in Virginia. So this is going to be close as it looks as though it is going to be. That is not good news for them. North Carolina, they did get a break in that the county board in Durham County extended voting hours when there were some voting problems there. That's part of the research triangle, where they knew that they had a solid vote to come in. So still hoping on North Carolina. Michigan making them nervous, as we've been reporting, not getting the vote that they had expected out of Detroit and Flint. This thing is getting so close, and you just showed the numbers in Ohio as well. One question that I have for all of you guys in there with all of the information at your fingertips.
Can we go back to Michigan? Because I'm not sure I saw it correctly. Was that it was double-digit difference here?
Maybe
71. 71 difference, and that's 12% 16 electoral votes. But I want to bring up Ohio as well, because Katie was on here about an hour or so ago saying, look, the word is Ohio is going to be crazy close, and that's what it appears to be right now. Trump, though, with a lead, but the difference, 162,000. What's the feeling in the room?
We are still watching Virginia. So is the rest of the country. Take a look at the results there so far. With 82% of the Virginia vote counted now, the numbers are Trump is leading 49% to Hillary Clinton's 46%.
We are back now from our NBC News Election Center in New York. This is a very tight race between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. Many states right now are too close to call. As I think we all suspected, it is going to be a long night. Let's go through some of those states right now and show you where things stand. First of all, as we look at the popular vote right now, Trump at 50%. Florida right now continues to be too close to call, 141,000 vote difference there. Michigan, it's emerged as a very important state down the stretch, 28,000 vote difference. That is too close to call. Ohio, too close to call. You see the difference there. That could go way, way into the night or early morning. North Carolina, too close to call, 56,000 vote difference. Let's look at Georgia. This Hillary Clinton drawing close there down the stretch. That is too close to call. You see the difference on the screen there. New Hampshire. New Hampshire right now is too close to call as well. A 1,700 vote difference with 22% of the votes in. And Pennsylvania, this is where Hillary Clinton wound up her campaign with that big rally with the Obamas last night. 156,000 vote difference, 16% of the vote in.
We had 94% in. Most of the vote is left is in Miami and Broward. There's more vote in Broward left than Dade. She's winning this 67-31.
That's a view of Democracy Plaza outside our studios at 30 Rock here in New York on what is a dramatic night that has even more drama on top of it. There's the national vote total right now. The popular vote, Trump ahead 49 47%. But folks, this is a night about the battleground states. We knew it would be, but it is far closer than many imagine. Florida right now, too close to call, 139,000 vote difference. Let's look at the state of Michigan here that Clinton was forced to defend down the stretch, a 50,000 vote difference, too close to call. Ohio, a perennial battleground state, too close to call. You see the difference there. North Carolina right now, an 84,000 vote difference, too close to call. Same story in Georgia, a state that Clinton was hoping to turn blue, very close there as well, too close. New Hampshire, look at New Hampshire right there, 1,400 votes separate the two of them. And Pennsylvania, also too close to call, the state that Hillary Clinton made her big finish last night. A lot of drama here on this night, and in the race to 270, here's where things stand. Based on the projections we've made so far, 137 in the Trump column, 104 to Hillary Clinton. And there's the map right now unfolding on the rink below us. That's a swath of red, a lot of gray still to be unfinished, which will tell the story of this night when they are filled in. Yep. We have another call here in the state of Missouri. And NBC News projects that Missouri will go to Donald Trump. Donald Trump will win. And let's look at where things stand right now. There's a Missouri call. Let's see where we are.
Somebody who's done a lot of governor campaigns in both Florida and Michigan, yep. There's one difference. Michigan has rural counties that are more Democratic in many places compared to Sunbelt and Southern states.
They have been.
Yeah, they have been. Will Trump really turn that over? And will Detroit vote and Flint what it normally does, or will it be under enough that Trump's overage in some of these places will make it? And Trump is doing well in some of these smaller counties right now.
We're quickly back from the break. We have a new projection. The state of Ohio, NBC News projects when the votes are counted, Ohio will go to Donald Trump. Donald Trump will win Ohio. Chuck Todd, you've been watching. Let's show you where that takes us in the race to 270 right now. As we come down on the ice, and right now it's 168 Trump, Clinton 109. You've been watching Florida. You don't think it's going well for Clinton there.
I don't, and I think North Carolina is trending Trump here. Look, first of all, Ohio, little historical nugget. Last time somebody didn't win the White House while winning Ohio was in 1960 in Richard Nixon. Ohio is, and no Republican, you have to win Ohio to win the White House. Trump has done it.
And as we come back from a break, we have a new projection. NBC News projects that Hillary Clinton will win in the state of Virginia, 13 electoral votes. Here's how it's shaking out right now. Clinton had it 47% over Trump.
Look, vote keeps coming in. She hasn't really narrowed the gap very well. It's just not there.
By the way, everybody talking about how Trump didn't have much of a get out the vote operation.
But didn't need it.
It is 11:30 in the East, and as we look at Democracy Plaza, NBC News projecting that Donald Trump is the apparent winner in Florida. Donald Trump, the apparent winner in Florida. It's a state that he called a must win, and he appears to be winning it, 29 electoral votes. Let's show you the vote count right now as it stands. 49% Trump, 48% Clinton. That's the vote, current vote count, 96% of the vote in Florida. Now, we also want to tell you that Utah, now we're getting a call on Utah, the state of Utah. The projected winner is Donald Trump in Utah. And let's look at how the votes break down in Utah. Okay, we're going to walk you through some of the other calls we made. You were away in your local coverage. California projected for Hillary Clinton. Hawaii for Hillary Clinton. Idaho is won by Donald Trump, the projected winner in Idaho. Oregon will go to Hillary Clinton. Clinton also the projected winner in Washington. And as we had noted earlier, Trump, the projected winner in North Carolina. So let's take you down on the ice and show you where the race to 270 stands right now. First, I'm sorry, we got a new one. This is a new projection in the state of Iowa. Donald Trump wins in Iowa. All right, now let's take you. There's the breakdown in Iowa right now. 50% Trump, 44% for Clinton. Now I think we can take you down and show you where things stand in the race to 270. Big change there with that last round. 228 for Trump, 209 for Clinton, as more and more states are now filled in. Some big ones still outstanding there. We continue to watch. That will likely turn this race one way or the other.
All right, I got to interrupt you. I got to go to Lester. We got a call in Georgia.
All right, we're making that projection now. NBC News projects that Donald Trump wins the state of Georgia. This has gone on a lot longer than many imagined it would, but 16 electoral votes, Trump wins Georgia. We also want to note very quickly, well, let's first of all look at the where that takes us in the race to 270. That puts Trump at 244, Clinton standing right now at 209. Let me just mention here very quickly, Arizona, Wisconsin, those have moved to the too close to call category. We're at the Clinton headquarters, long faces and tears. Here's the national vote right now, the popular vote, Trump with 48% to 47%. But as we knew going in, this is a story about battleground races. In the race to 270, Trump right now has climbed out ahead to 244 to Clinton's 209. There are some remaining states there here. They are all in the too close to call category, starting with Michigan, too close to call. Wisconsin, New Hampshire. And you can see some of these, the difference is 6,000, the difference in New Hampshire. Maine is too close to call. Minnesota is too close to call. Pennsylvania, part of Hillary Clinton's firewall, still too close to call. A 7,000 vote difference there. I don't know if you caught that. Nevada is too close to call. And Arizona, too close to call. These states will keep us up for a long time here. Welcome back. Our decision night in America has carried over into Wednesday morning here in the East Coast. And let's walk you through where we are. Alaska right now, we can say that is too early to call. We're looking at a slew of states that are too close, including New Hampshire right now with 82 votes currently separating the two of them. Pennsylvania right now, it is too close to call, but Trump has moved out slightly in front. To Michigan right now, too close to call, a 58,000 vote difference. Minnesota, too close to call. You see the difference there. In Maine, 17,000 vote difference, too close to call. And the same story for Wisconsin and also Arizona. And these are the states that that keep us all in suspense right now as we bring the camera down on the rink. Watch the states pop up in red and blue and look at that race to 270. Trump at 244, Clinton at 215.
Let's look at this. Wisconsin, the state of Michigan, and the state of Pennsylvania. Clinton was also hoping to flip the state of Arizona, but is trailing there as well.
As you can see, it is a Trump lead there.
Can Trump win without Pennsylvania, based on what's left?
My point is this. He can win, and let me back up here. He can win with any pairing, any combination. Look, he can win with just Pennsylvania and Arizona at this point. Look, he's 22 short. Okay, so she's got to win all of them, as we said. He only needs one of them at this point.
Reporting a source saying that Clinton has called Trump to concede the election.
And I've talked to somebody in the Clinton campaign. They've confirmed that. Piece of great reporting.
Here's Governor Pence, who didn't often seem on the same page with his running mate, but he is about to give the remarks.
This is a historic night. So let me say, it is my high honor and distinct privilege to introduce to you the President-elect of the United States of America, Donald Trump.
Thank you very much, everybody. Sorry to keep you waiting. Complicated business. Complicated. You will say, so many of you worked so hard for us.
But as Donald
you will
Trump
say that
continues to speak to the excited crowd here in New York, we can tell you our decision desk has now put Wisconsin and Pennsylvania and in the Trump column. He's the apparent winner.
And I can only say
that would make Trump the president-elect. And, of course, as he noted, Secretary Clinton had already called and conceded.
Hillary, you're fired. Fired.
Everybody's always blaming me for everything.
Now project the winner of the presidential race. CNN projects Donald Trump wins the presidency.